Why are you sweating so much? What's going on? Oh, you just started keto. Ah, I get it. Okay, yeah, that's probably why you're sweating a lot. This is commonly asked, and I notice it. If I cycle on and off of keto, it's a stark difference between keto and not keto with how much heat I produce during a workout. So, upon a lot of requests, let's break down what exactly is happening inside your body and why you're creating more heat. Now, this is a good thing, okay? It's not a bad thing. You know, I want to put that out there. Just because you're sweating a little bit more during a workout doesn't mean that there's just a bad thing going on. It means that your resting metabolic rate is possibly increasing, and there's a lot of data to back that up. So let's break down the biochemistry of why your body heat's going up. Hey, after this video, check out my friends at Ujido Matcha. There is a link down below in the description that you've got to check out. I am a huge matcha fan. I start my day with coffee, and then I switch over to matcha after that because I feel like the theanine gives me like this calming, cooling feeling in my body while still perking up my brain a little bit. I just like the way it makes me feel, and when it comes down to matcha green tea, there are a lot of imposters out there, but Ujido is legit. 187-year-old company, okay? They grow this matcha, harvest it in Japan in the right conditions using baby green tea leaves the way that it's supposed to be, harvested in the shade the way they're supposed to be, so the chlorophyll content's high. Anyhow, there's a link down below, and big thank you to Ujido for the continued support on this channel for a number of years. So that link's down below in the description. Okay, so there are a multitude of studies that have been talking about this, and I did a full video breaking down the new study, but let's take a look at why you increase so much heat while you're working out or just in general. Okay, so ketones increase what is called the expression of an uncoupling protein. Now, what that means is it actually increases the inefficiency of your cells. What the heck? Why would we want an inefficiency? Well, it doesn't decrease the efficiency of your body to create energy. It's just creating an additional inefficiency that your body dissipates energy as heat. You see, it looks like this. When we create energy, we have something called the electron transport chain, which admittedly is not the sexiest thing to talk about, but it makes a lot of sense. Ultimately, what's going on is electrons are passed down through this series of events, which, long story short, creates this like imbalance of hydrogen concentrations within our mitochondria, which produces energy. Now, bear with me. I know this sounds like it's going to be complicated gobbledygook that is useless, but it's real. Okay, inside of our mitochondria, we have a turbine, okay, and this turbine spins, and when that turbine spins, we create energy, okay? Just like a hydroelectric dam, just like a wind turbine. It's literally a turbine in our mitochondria. Well, the turbine spins because we have a concentration of hydrogen on one side and lack of concentration of hydrogen on the other. And our body always tries to find balance. In chemistry, there's always this equilibrium. So hydrogen is going to flow where there is less concentration to try to find the balance. Well, guess what? It flows through this turbine, spins the turbine. Okay, well, what happens on keto is studies have demonstrated that you have this thing called an uncoupling protein that gets expressed. And this uncoupling protein sits on the membrane right where this is happening. And guess what? It hijacks some of that energy that is created and it takes it for itself. Well, what does it do with it? It dissipates it as heat. It is a like the most ridiculously inefficient process within our body, but it does it. And it begs the question, like, why is this happening? Well, it could be a number of different reasons, but it's a good thing because it's keeping our metabolism high, okay, which explains why on the ketogenic diet, people's metabolisms don't drop the same way they do on other dietary patterns. But that's not the question at hand. The question at hand is, well, what's happening when we're creating energy, when we're working out? Well, a relatively new study had demonstrated there was a 128% increase in the respiration of our fat cells, but not necessarily in the energy production. So meaning there's almost a third more just energy output from a cell without actually creating energy, just more oxygen being breathed. So when you're working out, that ratio, that percentage is going to go up even more because a good portion of your energy is getting created and used for your workout. But also a good portion of the energy on a ketogenic diet is getting dissipated as heat. Okay, now this is happening at rest, but it's such a relatively small number at rest, you may not notice it. You may notice you run a little bit hotter at rest, but it just amplifies it and illuminates it while you're working out because that number is gonna increase. The more energy and the more hydrogen that's flowing through that turbine, the faster the turbine's spinning, sure, you create energy, but it also is going to increase the ratio that's taken up by these uncoupling proteins. This is really earth-shattering stuff because now we're seeing that, well, this is what makes the ketogenic diet so phenomenal for fat loss and weight loss, because it makes it so you can actually keep the weight off. So when you're increasing that sweating and that, like, that feeling that you think is kind of annoying, well, that's a very, very good thing, especially associated with a workout. And you'll probably notice, like I do, when I come off of a ketogenic diet, that doesn't happen as much. I notice, oh, cool, I'm not sweating as much. It's not nearly as big of a deal, right? Well, of course, I mean, it feels like everything's running efficiently because that's the way your body should be running. But on a ketogenic diet, these inefficiencies are going to allow your cells and your body to use more, and that's going to be a good thing. Okay, so it's putting you into a deeper deficit because a percentage of your energy is being allocated for random heat, okay? But it's also creating more heat, which is going to stimulate more uncoupling proteins, and it's going to stimulate more heat shock proteins and other positive effects of a ketogenic diet. So if you're not feeling that additional sweat, you don't feel like you're dripping a whole lot, consider getting a little stricter with keto. Or it might mean that it's time for a little bit of a break and a rewind because you're getting so fat adapted and so efficient at an inefficient process that it's time for you to switch it up. Come off of keto for a month and then go back on. But that explains why you are sweating so much during your workouts on a ketogenic diet. I'll see you tomorrow.